In this video, we're going to take a look at Pi Cloud Connect subscriptions. In a previous video, we walked through the process of creating publications. Part of that process was selecting a subset of our data that we wanted to share with other people, and then inviting them using their email addresses. So, from the subscription side, our process begins with an email. And here we have it. As you can see, the email shows us the name of the company that's inviting us, as well as the name of the publication. Hopefully, the publisher has used a descriptive name, so we know what we're looking at. In this video, I'm following Mike, who works for the Big Chippy Company. They're an ingredient supplier for the ice cream company we used in the publication video. The email tells us we can set up our subscription here on our Pi Cloud Connect portal. Before we do that, however, we need to make sure we have a place set up in our own infrastructure to receive that data. To do that, we're going to go to the Pi System Explorer and take a look at our AF database. We recommend creating a new AF database for each publication you subscribe to. This avoids any potential complications with overlapping tags. Again, since we may be dealing with lots of subscriptions, I'm going to use a descriptive title for my database. In this case, I know it's an ingredients list coming from the Nisqually Creamery Company, Lancaster site. We have one step left here in AF. In order to send data from the subscription into our AF database, we need to have at least one root element to point the data at. So now I'll go ahead and create one. Now that the AF database is ready to receive our subscription data, let's go to the portal and set it up. Now we'll navigate to our customer-specific portal. Note that my prefix here is Big Chip. I'll click on the Pi Cloud Connect tile to take me to the main Pi Cloud Connect page. Now, an important thing to note here is that even though we are creating a new subscription, the process begins at our publications list. Since Big Chippy is only intended to be a subscriber, I don't have any publications currently running. However, when I click the publications tile, you can see the publication that we've just been invited to. This is because your publications list shows all publications, both the ones that you have been invited to and the ones that you've created yourself. In the case of publications you've been invited to subscribe to, they will persist for 48 hours after you've been invited before disappearing. Now I'll highlight it and click subscribe. This brings us to a list of all the AF databases we are currently connected to. Note that the naming convention is server name followed by database name. This is particularly helpful when you're connected to multiple AF servers with multiple databases. I'm going to select the database I created, NCC Lancaster Ingredients. And now I can select that root element that I created. Now it's time to name my subscription. Again, it's helpful to give a descriptive name since you may be dealing with a lot of them. The data prefix will be added to any tags imported as part of the subscription. This is particularly useful for managing your subscription tags when you're using a Pi product that doesn't have that AF element tree available. Now we can click See Existing Subscriptions, and this takes us to our subscription page. Just like our publications, subscriptions are initially created in a stop state. So we'll need to highlight it and click Start Subscription. Now that the receiving progress is up to date, and we have a good status, we can head back to our AF database and see the data coming in. And here we go. The timestamp of our data is current with the system time. So to wrap up, subscribing to a publication begins with an email inviting you to subscribe. From there, we create a new database in AF and a new root element to send that data to. Once that's ready, we head to our portal and subscribe to that publication, which is found in our publications list. With a few simple clicks, that subscription is set up, and we're receiving data. Thank you for watching, and be sure to check out the other PyCloud Connect videos in this series.